Okay, right. New game. I think it's a puzzle game. Puzzle-esque. Oh, wow. Was easy enough. Oh, okay. So here we're making some. We are here at the International Syndicate for Criminal Theft and Robbery. Wish to congratulate you on being selected to be invited to our job interview. Due to your pedigree and previous accomplishments, you were chosen amongst hundreds of candidates to join our new job interview program. Your first task will be to find our secret office, which is hidden somewhere in the underground part of an old abandoned wastewater treatment facility in Bay District. Good luck. Okay, so we've got this weird note. Those numbers on it. And then there's. Okay, I guess that's the drain cover that we. Sewage cover. We went down on. Okay. I don't know, I can zoom in. All right. Can I pick it up? Okay. Only carry one item at a time. Anywhere that I can use this reel on? Oh. Okay. Okay. It's locked. Oh. Okay.
Welcome. Let's jump right into the practical portion of our job interview program. Since you have already made it down here, it means you're more competent than most of the people who seek to join our prestigious organization. Now, all that is left to do is to give you a small hint to help you on your way. You will find it on this audio reel.
Okay. I need to play it again.
Welcome. Let's jump right into the to help you on your way. You will find it on this audio reel.
Find it on the audio reel. Nothing on the actual tape. There's nothing written on it. There's no engravements physically. So is it from the audio then? Find it on the audio. What is this? What does all those numbers mean? That's what we need to figure out. Are they different lines? Different lines of codes. So like 72804. Oh, so it's four. It's a 4-digit 1429 then? No. This is on this audio wheel. Oh, there we go.
Uh-huh.
So, is it right from the triangle up, right, down, diagonal? Okay. So from the triangle up, is 5, right is 8, 2, 3, 5, 8, 2, 3. Ooh. Love to hear that sound.
Boom.
Oh, very long strides. Weights. Why would I need to carry weights? Alright, so we got different colours here.
Okay.
And many weights. Ah, see. It's like handkerchiefs. I need to, why the weights though? What do the weights mean? So we had different colour handkerchiefs. Is there any handkerchiefs through here?
No.
Right. So let's put that down. Okay. Oh, there's another one there. So, did we go from, oh, that's another one there. Descending order? Then that one. So does each line correlate to the different floors? So like that colour was the first, was the highest. Then that would be at the top. So then the second one would be that one. So then that one would go there, right? And then the next one, not that one, was it? Wait, no. And that one. Do I have to do more stuff with the weights? What's up with that? Why do I need to...
Ah, wait.
This... Do we have to make it drop into those holes? Surely we should have that there.
Need more weight. Need more weight.
More weights. Bang. Ooh. That's close. Need one more. Okay. Wait. That one isn't. So does one need to come off here?
No.
No, they're both in, right?
No.
But no more weights can fit on, can they? One more needs to... Oh, wait. Is that another... Look at that! Is that a collar? Too heavy. Okay. Right, I've only just noticed that some weights have two weights on them, like two balls on them, instead of one. So, I need to find how... See, if they got to be specific depth then, or what they use before anything happens with... The other ones. Is there, wait, is there any other weights? Wait, what's that? Collectible number two? Where's collectible number one?
Hold on a minute.
I want to get collectible number one. I can't find collectible number one, but we need to go back to these weights, because I don't understand. Huh. Anything on this? So you might make some... Alright, I don't think there's anything left to do with that. Thinking maybe we have to change that top one there to a double, maybe. So right, I'm gonna change that one to a double. Alright, change that one to a single. Wait, has that done it? No. Mm-hmm. Right, and now if I take that double off. So take that single off. Put that double on. A single one. On. Now, reach. It doesn't have to be a double, like two doubles on there. Just take all the weights off. Right, so if you don't get in by now, you see the what do you call it? The actual hatch thing. Okay. They're meant to be level. That's why I'm stupid. I had it right the whole time. Yet I still figure and muddle around with the weights. I'm just dumb. Collectible number one. Let's go. Okay, we've got all the collectibles so far at least. See, I'm not sure if it is that we have to. Get a double weight on the top. But then surely it wouldn't. There's four hooks. Right. On this one. On this one. Wait, what? How many hooks are there? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Just had a thought. Something got. I've just had a thought. I'm thinking, has something got to slot through these? I'm thinking, if you slot something through. You slot something through the middle and then through those little peg things. Could you not then just take all the weights off and it'll lift everything itself? Yes, it really took me that long for my brain to function that I needed to use a pipe to slot through each like hook so that I could take all the weights off and then it would lift up. I am stupid. Huh? Then what about that? Because now I can just get through. Locked. A weirdly shaped lock. Metal. I told you.
Oh, mate.
Oh, look at how beautiful that is. Look at it. Bang. 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 Oh, wait.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Let's be smart now, and let's not get carried away. Well, I'm not in that. Is this going to be a nightmare? Oh, yes. Look at that! A wrench. So it wasn't a weirdly shaped key, it was a wrench we were looking for. Oh, that is beautiful.
Another thing.
Oh, why? Wait, no. Oh, wait, no, this thing's right here.
Congratulations on making it this far. By getting here, you have shown exceptional competence and skills. While there are still many challenges ahead of you, I'm sure you have what it takes to overcome them. And remember, when you find yourself up against a wall, the answer might lay just behind it. There is always light at the end of the tunnel.
Alright, you said something about a wall. Okay.
Is there a way to move this?
Oh, no, but I guess I will have to. I'll have to open. To open this first, and when I open the doors, it will just be a hole,
and then I'll come up through there.
Right, so we need 5-letter combination, 5-number combination. This, I don't think we can just guess what it is. If we're lucky. Right, see, we've got no clues for this, right? There's something on. Got to be something to do with this, right? Like. There's something inside of it. I've just noticed that there's these markings. Wait, I've... You see these stains on the box? I've now somehow lined these up correctly, because look, this stain here is lined up with the on the floor correctly, and look, mark the scratch there. It's lined up. The five's there. See how none of that lines up? So, what if... See, now that lines up, so... Oh, I love it. So if you don't get it, you see these stains and marks, they all line with each other. See how there's like a little fingerprint scratch there, lines up together, and that stain, this big stain here, lines with the two. Oh, valve open. What's this? Oh. I want to remind everyone to be careful with all these old rusted pipes of crap. If the system is even barely working, you shouldn't touch any of the pressure balancing units. The safety shutoff valve finally got permanently stuck, and we currently not have any replacement parts. In case of absolute emergency, you can use this safety override. So, I'm going to remember it by saying right, middle, left, middle, right, right, middle, left, middle, right. Right, middle, left, middle, right. Right, middle, left, middle, right. Boom! And the light's on. Oh my god. Valve open. Oh wait, no. Okay, what did I do? Right, I'm going to say that I think that these ones are 43. Alright, yeah, I'm going to say that this one is 43. And I was right. I put 43. Because these are all in a line. Wait, what if it's the same thing for these then? So not that one's not going to be 43. 4, 32, 40, 44, and 2. Do you have to add them? Surely not, because then that one would be ridiculous. This one might take me a while. So what have we got? Right, we've got 76, 54, 45 and 67.
Then what does that mean?
I just use an old trick. I don't get the smarts of it, so I'm just gonna do the simple thing. Wait, 16? Is it a... It must be an ad then. It must be an ad edition thing.
Hold on, let me get a calculator.
Equals
102.
No. Then.
Okay, well.
Again, the question thing. Jesus. Okay. So then what's wrong with this? What's up with this one? We'll do it the other way. What was that? That's the most simplest way to do it. If any of you are struggling on lock sequences, that is literally the easiest way to do it. That's why you have four column locks, so then you don't get easy stuff like that. And what is happening? Oh. Whoa! BGEBBA. BGE. Oh no. E. Right, it was BGEBBA. So BG. EBBA. B. G. E. B. B. Hey. I. Hey,
I don't need that anymore. Symbols now.
Okay.
There is a box with a lock on.
Ah, see? These are why you have these column locks. So now, it would take far longer to do it.
Is the other room to play the recording?
Since you have made it this far, you must have phenomenal lock cracking skills. Mm. However, not all locks can be cracked. In those cases, you need to be able to figure out the lock's combination based on the victim's preferences. For example, people often tend to set the combinations on their safes and suitcases based on their birthdays or their loved ones' birthdays. Or sometimes they use the year when their favorite painting was painted. Or maybe they use the best vintage of their favorite wine as the combination. You never know.
I have a painting. And there certainly is no wines.
But I had a painting. So I'm going to guess I need to use that painting's year, which is 1865, on this. Excuse me. Excuse me. Hello. Right, this painting was painted in 1865 by a young artist who was known as eccentric genius. Oh, known as an eccentric. Okay. According to the artist, the painting is currently on Hockey Relief Society overuse and boring brick buildings, its keen creativity and joy of living. This painting went unappreciated for a long time until it was rediscovered by a famed artist, fame art centric Jones Niemeyer. Yeah. Seemed like a very boring. Right, that's collectible now. Oh dear. Okay. Oh, how did I guess? Oh, wow. That is amazing. 1950. Beautiful. Okay, what is this? Okay, weird circle. Right, the state of the button on the top of the left corner must match with the. The state of the button on the top left corner must match the button on the bottom right corner. If a button has a circle on it, the button on its left side must be in. If there are two horizontally adjacent buttons with solid symbols on them, the buttons below them must be in. The middle row must have exactly two buttons which are in. Oh my god, out of the. Right, hold on. Right, let's. The state of the button on the top left corner must match with the button. The state of the. Right, the state of the button on the top left corner must match with the button on the bottom right. So that means out then. Yes? If a button has a circle on it, the button on its left side must be in.
Okay, usually I would cut a lot of this, but just to see how long it took me is ridiculously funny. So I'm going to leave this whole bit in.
Circle, circle. If a button has a circle on it, the button on its left side must be in. So that one and then that one. Because they're the only two buttons that have a circle on left of it. No. That are next to a circle. If there are two horizontally adjacent buttons. Wait, if there are two horizontally. Oh, that makes it better. There we go. If there are two horizontally adjacent buttons with solid symbols on them, the button below. So that one and that one. There are two horizontally. No. No. Use them two. Okay, not yet then. The state of. But the state of the top left one. What one must be the same? The middle row must have exactly two buttons which are in, only one at the moment. out of the buttons with the solid symbols on them, an odd number of them should be out. If there were three buttons on the bottom row, the middle one of them must be in. At least one button with a square on it must be in. The button with the solid triangle on it and the button with the solid circles on it must be opposite, in opposite states. What? The button with the solid triangle, this one, and the button with the solid triangle on it, with the solid circles on it, must be opposite. Yeah, so that one. So then that one must be in, because it said two buttons must be in the middle. If the button with the large hollow triangle on it is in, then the two buttons with the small circles on it must be in. Huh? Then the button with a small circle on it must be also in. A small triangle must be in. The number of the buttons with the number of buttons with squares on them, which are out, must be exactly. State of the buttons with solid circles on it must not match the state of any other adjacent. Oh, my brain! Oh my god. Right, this is another. Right, let's start from another moment of me being stupid again. I was one click away from opening the safe, but no. I decided to reset them all and try all over again when I did not need to. Corner must match. Okay, that's fine. If a button has a circle on it, the button on its left side must be in. That one and that one. If there are two horizontally adjacent buttons with solid symbols on them, the button below must be in. There are two horizontally adjacent buttons with solid symbols on them. So then that one. And that one. So then that one must go in. Okay, not yet. Oh. If there are three buttons, if there are three buttons on the bottom row of the middle, one of them must be in. That one. Okay, that's good. At least one button with a square on it must be in. At least one. Yeah. Out of the number of buttons with hollow symbols on them, an even number of them. Yeah. If a button with a large hollow triangle on it is in, yeah, then the button with the small circle on it must also be in. The small triangle must be in. The number of buttons with squares on them, which are out, must be exactly zero. The number of buttons with squares on them, the state of the buttons with a solid circle on it, the state of the button. Remember, the solid circle on it must not match the state of any other JSON button. I've never been so confused in my life. I mean, really, like, this is... That took me way too long. Oh. Acceptable. There's another wine, and then there's...
wine.
Nope. Nope.
Okay. Is there any other...
fixes?
Is this another guessing game?
Well, by the sounds of that, it sounded like it was right. That sounded horrible. I don't know. Unless there was anything in the other room. I mean,
since you have made it this far, you must have phenomenal lock-cracking skills. However, not all locks can be cracked. In those cases, you need to be able to figure out the lock's combination based on the victim's preferences. For example, people often tend to set the combinations on their safes and suitcases based on their birthdays or their loved ones' birthdays.
Don't know that one.
Or sometimes they use the year when their favorite painting was painted. Or maybe they use the best vintage of their favorite wine as the combination. You never know.
Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. I'm surprised I didn't think of that earlier. Right. The long one first.
So you didn't use that one at all. Right, I need to listen to it again.
Since you have made it this far, you must have phenomenal lock cracking skills. However, not all locks can be. In those cases, you need to be able to figure out the lock's combination based on the victim's preferences. For example, people often tend to set the combinations on their safes and suitcases based on their birthdays or their loved ones' birthdays. Or sometimes they use the year when their favorite painting was painted. Or maybe they use the best vintage of their favorite wine as the combination. You never know.
Oh, my brain. I'm looking out for collectibles. I'm sorry, what? Oh, you are joking. What is this? Wow, I've got a mop. How amazing. Okay. May I ask what I do with mop? I'm just completely guessing. I'm just praying for something. But again, there is thousands of variables. So,
do with you. What do you mean? Why can I grab a mop? Oh, there are five rows. See. Oh. Wait. No, never mind. I'm just thinking. How many clicks each way? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, this is. So is it just one specific? It must be, right? Two, three triangles for no circles. 1, 2, 3. That thing. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, no fifth, 1, 2, no, 1, 2, 1, 2. 3. Alright, so there isn't 5. Of any of these shapes. I've just recognised that that square, and that square are not filled out the exact same that this side isn't either. But if you look on this one, that if you try to follow one of these blank spaces, see, look, there's a path here. If you look on the other side, it blocks. And it blocks. But this is a clear path on each of these, so I'm going to reckon that's that, 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 and then, oh,
really? Right, I'm gonna call this one here, and then try tomorrow or something, because I really thought that was it. Yeah, I'm gonna finish this one next time. Anyway, thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the next one. Right, I know I said I was going, but I've just realised something. Okay. And I was just looking back in these sewers, right, and I thought I'd look for a collectible. Still can't find any. Actually, there might be one up here. No, never mind. And I recognise, and I just saw this. Would you look at that? They look like a symbol. And it's covered in a load of filth. And I know how I can clean that. I got them up earlier. Wonder what I can do. Look at that. Okay. Right, so it's actually some symbols mixed together. So you've got a circle and a hexagon mixed up, triangle and a semicircle mixed up, four leaf clover and a star, that thing and a square in it. And a circle with a star, and I'm gonna say a clover with an X. So yeah, so I reckon, well, let's go back and have a look. No, right, I'm going to save it for next time, but I'll now have a better idea what to do. Now, I will definitely go. Goodbye.